Okay. Hi everyone, welcome once again to our exclusive value series that's known as the Right Angle at God Gifted Camreras. I'm Trups S. Sawant, founder of True Copy again, and I'm here today to share a very unique case with you of a businessman. So to share the story how it all began. I was attending a corporate event and wherein a businessman had come and approached me, where firstly he didn't believe in the science of handwriting analysis. So just to try and test it, he randomly submitted his handwriting sample, just a few lines and his signature. And then he shared that identify one trait in my handwriting which had nobody has ever till date tried to identify or known about me, right? So apparently, the writing was a big surprise to me, which we would be sharing with you as well. And a very, very dangerous, I can say one of the most dangerous traits what I saw in his handwriting is known as the felon's claw. Okay, what do you mean by a claw in the writing? When you make an artificial formation, a curvy formation on the left side of your handwriting, so that can appear in any of the uppercase letters like T, your own initials, it could be letter J, it can be letter D in the small letters if I talk about, the letter A, we'll show you the samples as well. So claw in every letter reflects someone who is an extremely sweet talker. So the first thing what I asked is, do you love connecting and talking to people? You love appreciating them, of course, in combination with other traits. And he agreed. He said, yeah, that's a very generic one. Okay, so as we have to move step by step forward, next question I asked him was, have you been through a phase in life where people usually, you know, you are friendly with tend to cheat you? And he was zapped. He was amazed. He said, exactly what I'm going through right now. So apparently he is into a business with partnership of a mid-sized firm, and again his partner has cheated on him in terms of the legal documentations in that case. However, as per his handwriting, it's not just the environment to be blamed. So the next question when I asked him was, when you connect with people, or rather when you talk to them very politely, you become friendly with them, do you also have a habit at times of lying, or maybe, you know, you would not even want to share the whole truth to them? It can be as good as taking loan from someone, paying it off from another person, taking it from another person and paying it off, because there was a blockage in finance as well, what I could see in his handwriting. He just said, I can't lie to you at least, but yes, I do that. I definitely do that. In business, there are occasions where we have to lie. So here the pattern is what basically, it's basically the law of universe. What you give is what you get back. So coming back to the pattern in the handwriting formation was, he had developed a personality trait wherein he would be extremely sweet talker with everybody around him. It could be his seniors, it could be his subordinates in his corporate life in the past, or it could be now as a businessman with his clients. However, once people start developing faith in him, he makes the first move to gradually backstab them, which is intentional and at times unintentional, but that's a part of his personality trait, because of which now the clients don't trust him, and again his business as well is affected, which he agreed to. So then we helped him with, of course, a couple of therapies, modalities in alternative healing, as well as change in the stroke in his handwriting. And he is practicing it right now. So he connected with me just a week ago that it's been almost 2 months. I am trying to make the change, but it's difficult, definitely, because it's a part of your subconscious trait. Now, consciously, you're making an attempt to bring in a change. It does take time, but what you need is acceptance and patience for it. Another very common trait that was seen in his handwriting, or rather not very common, is I asked him a next question that, do you feel, or rather when you were a child, did you feel that your father had been cheated by a couple of people around him? Again, he agreed. But as a child, a very subconscious imprint what he also had about his father was to be blamed for whatever financial losses they have had in his father's business also. So somewhere he considered his father to be a cheat as well. To which again he agreed, and definitely there seemed to be a big dispute between the father figure and the son. So this trait is again being carried forward under revenge, under an attitude of, you know, very negative influence. And that's where he has developed to a very larger scale, from a child to a teen to an adult today. So again, what we spoke about today is the claw. If you have it in your writing, please do connect with us as soon as possible to make the corrections where required. Otherwise, the repercussions could be really dangerous for you and for the people around. So thank you so much for watching me today on the topic again, the claw, at our value series of handwriting analysis, The Right Angle. Take care and good day.